Welcome to my series about Cheat Engine. In this episode, I'll try to explain step 3 of the graphical tutorial. In this step, we must make all these platforms green and then go to the door. The problem is that these enemies will block the door and they are one hit kill. So what we're gonna do in this episode is move them out of the way. To do that, we must first find out how the access system works in this game. Luckily, we have a player that we can control. So let's start by that. Make sure we connect to the correct process. Select all type since we don't know what type it is. And let's start. Select simple values only will greatly help you find the XI position, because very often the position system will be within a human readable range. So let's start a known initial value. Changed value. No, it just changed, of course. Just repeat this a few times. I may fast forward this or skip. And you can also use the pause button to help you. And I think this is already the address we can use, but or this one, but let's see. Well, this address looks to be correct, so let's freeze it. And there you have it, we have found the X position of the player. Now, the code that accesses the player is not the same as the enemy, so that's not that helpful, but we now know that -1 is the left side and +1 is the right side. So we can use that to find the coordinate system of the enemy. So let's start a new scan, float, an initial value, and start. Let's try this one. So it got changed. Well, actually, let's start a new one since I don't know when I started it. So now it got and to the right, so increased value, increased value, keeps on increasing, actually it's going the wrong side now, so let's go, but I don't know what it was, so load the previous value list, forgotten value scan. And now it's a decreased value. And there we have it. We found the coordinate of the enemy. Now let's find out what writes to this address. And there we go. In its own, this is not that handy, so let's look at the memory itself. Change display type to a float, and we have the X position, and usually the I position is nearby. So maybe this 0.9 is it, so let's change it to 0. And as you can see, it's now in this location, and if we change it to 2, it's basically out of the game, nowhere to be seen. Now let's do this also for the other players, but the problem is we don't know the addresses, but that's why you have this instruction. And there we have it, the addresses of the other players. So let's add these to the list. Now that I have these three addresses, we can just change them to the next one. So we have the I coordinate. And we can change them to 2. And freeze them. So when they start moving to the door, they won't actually be able to. So let's do this game first. I'll probably fast forward this because I will fail this many times. I can of course just simply cheat on this by just changing an integer value to 12 or how many lines these are, but you can also just play this game if you like. Oops. And there you go. As you can see, the enemies are trying to go there constantly, which makes this a little bit more tricky than initially assumed. But let's see if we can at least touch the door. And yes, we have made it to the door, and this solves the tutorial. And since we did not use any code injections, we have beaten the integrity check. I will go more into this next time. I hope this has been educational for you, and see you next time.